Dear Industry Expo and B2B Meetings participants, it is my great pleasure to open the 8th edition of the Industry Expo and B2B Meetings. We are facing challenging times, and now more than ever, we need to be united and to work together for better business, for a better world. Even this year, we are exclusively online due to the COVID-19 situation and the restriction imposed by the authorities, we adapt in order to provide best solutions to support the process of developing new businesses and to improve relations with the existing clients, suppliers, and collaborators. Today, at the main presentation, I have three guests. Adrian Sandu, Executive Secretary and member of the board of the Romanian Automobile Constructor Association. Welcome, Adrian.
Hello, everyone.
Thank you, Adrian. Cristian Bliotu, Managing Director, Effective Flux. Welcome, Cristi.
Well, good morning. Welcome, everybody.
Cristi, Gheorghe Kazan, General Manager, Hofag Engineering. Welcome, Gigi.
Good morning, everybody.
So the first presentation is Automotive Industry Statistics and Trends. The speaker, Adrian Sandu, as already mentioned. Adrian, please start your presentation.
Thank you, Claudio. Glad to see you again, even if we are again online. In this pandemic situation, we cannot meet face-to-face, but we hope that the next event that you are organizing in November in March, April, to be with live audience and to shake hands again as friends and collaborators. I will make a short update about the automotive industry and I'll share my screen. I hope you can see it now. The present. Yeah.
Yes.
So last year we passed through difficult times. There are always more than 600 companies involved in the automotive industry. The number of direct employees kept the same level as in 2019. The share of total GDP of Romania generated by the automotive industry remained at 14%, which means that the automotive industry still remains the most important sector of the Romanian economy. The total exports reach 17 billion euros, 27% of national export, of course, is a decrease compared to 2019 because of the 2 months of the lockdown last year. And the three export companies are from all the Romanian economy are all from the automotive industry, Dacia, Ford, and Daimler. As actors, Dacia is still the main actor in the automotive industry with a turnover higher than 4 billion euros. It has two plants, one mechanical and chassis plant, and one for vehicle assembly, and also an important logistic hub which deliver components and parts to other plants of the Renault Alliance worldwide. The second main actor on this player, it's Ford in Craiova with two plants, one for engines and one for vehicle plants. It manufactures two models and it also manufactured the first hybrid vehicle to be made in Romania, which is the Puma. As suppliers, we have suppliers all over the map of our country, mainly concentrated in the western side of Europe, of Romania, due to the proximity to Europe and to their customers, we must mention that the part from the suppliers, from the turnover generated by the suppliers, it's more than 70%. So Romania is an important base for suppliers for the automotive industry. We are having suppliers for all types of parts, except two or three parts which are necessary for the assembly of a vehicle. We need alloy wheels. So if a company that is present here today is manufacturing alloy wheels, please contact me because I have an important business for you. And as you can see here on the slides, we can manufacture almost everything in Romania. Current situation and some figures. We are at 9 months at the production of 315,000 units. With this crisis of electronic components, I will explain a little bit later. We hope to reach the same level as last year as production of vehicles. Concerning the market for vehicles, we also are still on the same level of last year, and we have as the most East European countries, there is an issue with used car registration, cars imported from Western Europe. The total turnover generated by the automotive industry last year is around 26.4 billion euros, minus 15% compared to 2019. As I mentioned before, due to the fact that we have 2 months of lockdown last year, caused by the pandemic evolution. We are facing a lot of challenges. These are the most important, and these are difficult times for the automotive industry. And not only, we have the coronavirus last year. Now we have a crisis of electronic components. I will detail it. But we also facing changing in the mobility. We are seeing in Europe, and not only, changing in the mobilities with a lot of push from the European Commission towards electrification of vehicles, and lowering emissions delivered by cars and by the transport, which put a lot of pressure on the OEMs. But we also are facing a huge challenge now with rising prices for raw materials, for energy, and this puts a lot of pressure on the vehicle manufacturers, but also on the suppliers, which have to deal with new trouble. Concerning the semiconductor, I will detail a little bit. A vehicle can carry up to 100 electronic components and between 20 to 40 microcontrollers that represents almost 35% of the cost of the vehicles. If we are talking about highly technical vehicles and luxury vehicles, those vehicles are gathering more and more electronics, from infotainment to security systems to communication systems. And overall, the automotive industry consumes around 10% of all microchips sold in the world. Only Europe consumes almost 40% of the semiconductor supply. So there are 185 plants for vehicles in Europe. And at this point, there is no vehicle manufacturer in the world that doesn't need an electronic component. Even if we are talking about building vehicles like bulldozer or heavy trucks, they are all having on their scheme of build electronic components. And the crisis might grow more with the increase in demand for electric vehicles, because the electric vehicles are in the need for more than 100 electronic components per vehicle. So this problem is rising, and it's still present not only in Romania or in Europe, but it's a global problem at this point. And the German automotive industry, which is the most important in Europe, is facing the worst semiconductor supply shortage in 40 years. The European Union is now trying to take some quick measures, but unfortunately, in order to deliver a plant for semiconductors, you need at least 2 years, and the investment is at the level of around 1.5 to billion euros. So it will take a little bit of time until this will stop. Concerning raw material prices, everyone is concerned about how this will go in the next period. You can see on the right a graph of the price of electricity in UK, how it went up. And in Europe, concerning gas, we are seeing now that the Russian supplier for gas is now facing some, let's say, difficulties. But I think there are political difficulties to supply gas to Western Europe. So every country has trouble with gas supply. Although the prices were going up, there is a huge need for gas and electricity at this point. There are also crises of prices in other fields like lithium, cobalt, steel, rubber, or plastic. All these materials are used in order to build a vehicle, and for electric vehicle, the price of lithium is very important, and also the price of electricity that it's used by that vehicles. Concerning electrification, I was telling you earlier that the European Commission pushes towards electrification. The program that they launched, the package that they launched, Fit for 55, requires that in 2030 the emission from vehicles to be around zero. So there will be no vehicle except full electric vehicles to apply with that requirement. So at this point, only 5.4% of the cars sold last year were battery electric, full electric. So you can see that the share of those vehicles in the market is still very low. The demand, what is important to say, that is that there is still a demand for traditional vehicles with gasoline and diesel engines, a huge demand. Of course, the share of hybrid vehicles is increasing, but not as fast as someone demands. And we will have a huge problem concerning electricity. As you see, the prices are going up, and are going up because also the plants used to produce electricity that were using coals or coal or gas or natural gas or oil were stopped, were out of the system. And now with the increase of electricity prices, there are some member states that are thinking to restart those plants in order to have enough electricity for their own consumption. This is also will be the case of Romania, I believe, in the next year. So we will see how we can produce the electricity needed for the new electric vehicles that will need this electricity. And there is also an issue concerning the infrastructure. For example, in Romania, we have a plug for supplying an electric vehicles, one plug to 200 kilometers of road. So the development of the charging infrastructure is very important and necessary in order to deliver electricity to the cars and in order to have an increase of this market for vehicles. You can see here the shares, as I explained you earlier, or there is the demand for petrol and diesel cars is still at 41% in Europe. In Romania, only 11% of the total market it's represented by battery and hybrid electric vehicles. And of course, we have incentives offered by the Romanian state in order to purchase a hybrid on electric cars. The incentive can go up to 10,000 euro per vehicle. What can we do and what are the solutions in these difficult times? Of course, we need to innovate and to apply the newest and the best technical solution available. Digitalization, automatization are solutions for this. We also have to increase our quality control and to implement the best solutions for our production processes. But we also need support from the state, and we are in continuous dialogue with the Romanian authorities. And one of the support is the implementation of Kurzarbeit also in Romania. So the flexible time, working time, it's available as legislation in Romania. Our priorities are mainly four: education, investment in education. We need vocational school, dual schools, technical schools, universities, and R&D. We also need a stable car market and a regulated one. We must continue the development of transport infrastructure. We are talking about the roads, but also railway system. And we are, as a main priority of in this period, is local integration of components and suppliers. In Romania, Dacia and Ford are highly supported of this program. So if you are manufacturing parts and components for the automotive industry, we are available for you to offer you information. Who you are? We are a public utility state with recognized association. So we are an official dialogue for the Romanian authorities concerning automotive industry. We are having more than 170 companies in the automotive industry covering all the fields. And we are also the main partner for dialogue at the European level, being an associate member of the European Automobile Manufacturer Associations in Brussels. So we are the voice of the automotive industry in Romania and also the representative of this sector at European level. If you have questions, I'm available, and Claudio can also send you my contact details if you need support for having contacts with Dacia or Ford for the localization process. Thank you, Claudio.
Thank you, Adrian. Thank you for your presentation. Our next presentation is Digitalization in Production, Challenges and Examples. The speaker, Cristian Bleotu, Managing Director, Effective Flux. Cristi, if you are ready, please proceed.
Yes, I'm ready. So just to start the presentation. Okay. Hello, everybody. My name is Cristian Bleotu. As already Claudiu mentioned, I'm leading a consulting company, delivering also in automotive. So the subject will be one which is linked to the today trend of digitalization, but digging more what is in between a digitalized company and starting from a certain situation, because these are different from the company to company. We are a consulting company, as I said. We have over 300 companies as a customers. They are maybe 30-40% from automotive companies, including Tier 1 suppliers, but we also have, let's say, lower level of suppliers in automotive or non-automotive suppliers. There are companies between, let's say, 20 employees and 10,000 employees. So this gives us a large range of the organization to be seen and to understand what is on the Romanian, but not only Romanian market. We are covering consulting, training, and recently digitalization as a desire to integrate our consulting and training services with the new trends. We cover a large subject, both for consulting and training. Each of these one are linked to the digitalization process, even if we speak about the production, like capacity increase, and or maybe problem with late deliveries or process optimization, which is linked with the cost and is based on the time study or line balancing, what is the case. Of course, quality is part of the cost also, and as already Adrian mentioned, we have to be more and more careful with the quality as an important part of the cost. There are different methods or methodologies to control the performance of our processes, such as lean. Also logistic, it takes a lot of part of the cost, and especially today with all this problem in supplying the parts for logistic, it's one of the part on which everybody looks to make his job as better as possible. Maintenance, but also Six Sigma, or including HR, they are part of our job also. As part of digitalization, we went on few directions. One is for a product which is allowing to make a simulation for the layout. This means before to implement any line or any new warehouse, you can test to see if your layout or your design is the one which assures the capability. We also consider the fact that in order to managing the performance of the process or to have a better control quality system, then you need also a platform. We also have a small product that you can see it a little bit later on, which is actually Pokaioke based on augmented reality. Also, we need, including for digitalization, to make data analysis. So here we have from the base statistical tools, but also using certain dedicated softwares. And of course, for the personal part, which is an important part of any company processes, there is also a product which is going to the digitalization. A few words about the area which I said that I would like to focus on, it's related to why we need so-called industrialization, industry 4.0, digitalization, or whatever you want to call it. Actually, what's happened on the market, what we are feeling here, but I think it's a worldwide, one of the things is that the direct costs are increasing. It's more and more difficult to find out qualified employees and generally to find out employees. Then the product gets more and more complex, so this put a lot of pressure on the new product implementation, but also on managing the performance in the current production. Then many companies are looking to work with small lot sizes because you don't know what's happening in 2 or 3 weeks and you don't want to get the money blocked in your stocks. And also we need to remain competitive. So we need to look around in our organization and to improve continuously our performance. There are just some of the reasons why we need this industry 4.0. As a key challenges to implement, some of them from at least my perspective is that you need to invest some money and you need to access this money. This maybe is not the highest problem because usually you can access some financing, or you can go to the bank. So this is one point which usually can be solved. But also, and maybe this is one of the most important, is it takes time on people. It's not just you pay an external supplier, it does for you. You need to work along with him so that the project is getting you the desired result. Also, when we are not overloaded, usually we don't have maybe enough money. When you have a lot of projects, so we have money, we don't have time. So when to implement is one also of the challenges. Another thing is to find out the right supplier for the equipment, for the technology, maybe for consulting, because you need to be sure that it is enough experience that it can ensure your result. There is also another thing which we see on the market. Sometimes the customer, they don't know exactly what they need. They know what they want, which is not all the time the same thing. So as a consultant, you need to, let's say, to work a little bit with the customer to make him understand that if you want to reach certain objective, maybe the path that he proposed to you is not the one which will lead to these results. Another thing which also we face it is the fact that the starting point from the company is not the same. There are companies which are already very developed, so they have different system already in place on a certain level. They have, a real quality management system or a business system or a lean deployment. So they start at the center level, they're already gathering the data, analyzing the performance. So the step from this company to the digitalization is not so big. But there are also companies which want to go to the digitalization, but they have none of these systems, depending on the industry, but also depending to the size of the company. So in this case, we don't speak about the same thing. I mean, it's difficult to jump straight from the level that you are to the digitalization level in the moment that you don't collect any data, you don't measure the performance. So there are several steps in between that you need to consider. Such as, first of all, you might need to have a larger view. You need to understand what's your current status of the company, what's the context around you. Do we measure the performance in this moment or not? What are the recent projects and what are the goals that you targeted? So there are some of the things at least that you need to consider. If you only consider, let's say, I want to buy a software and to implement it, and this way my production become better, okay, you can do it, but it's your money. But it might be that you don't reach what you need, because you need to consider all the variables and then to develop an action plan. Because as we know, there are at least six large variables which influence any process. So I need to consider all of them, regardless if it is about man, machine, method, and the others. Only after that, then you might have the chance, of course, with the right implementation, right supplier, to reach your results. And you can see that because you should have at that point a performance measurement system, which will allow you to check, yes, I move from a lower level to a higher level of performance, or at least the key indicator. And this system will also allow you to maintain a continuous improvement, because looking to these indicators, you can see where you have to work around and to start again to make the improvement. Okay, even if we speak about some system, I mentioned to you one of the products, which is a 3D layout simulation system, which actually allows you to test your design before to implement the machine to install in the building, let's say something like that. You need to understand how you measure the performance of the system. What are the relevant KPIs and how do you calculate it? And once you have this KPI calculated, as can be seen in this image, then you need to understand what is it there. I mean, in this case, at the end of this small movie, we can collect some data such as, okay, what is the efficiency of this manufacturing cell? And you might see that this is below what we expected. Maybe this is 80%. And where is the problem coming from? So you can check from each operator or each operation and to see that It's a problem. It's getting down and down from the operation to operation. Why is this happening? Because actually the idle time, the waiting time, it's actually increasing from operator to operator. So this allows you to take some measure. Okay. The same situation, just that we speak machine running line, in this case, some robots, the perspective is somehow similar. Of course, the indicator will be a little bit different. In this case, we need to understand that we measure with OE. What is the OE? Is it OE correctly calculated? Because I saw many times on the market that they are not considering all the variables. Also, some other indicators specific in this case are MTTR, MTBF. What does it mean, this one? How are these reflecting the maintenance performance and how these are supporting me to improve it? If I don't understand them, if I don't take any measures later on, then I pay the money for nothing for any program such as this one. So I have to accelerate a little bit. Okay, other case study is, let's say that I'm working in automotive, I'm tire one supplier or tire two, and I have to implement a system in order to calculate the so-called stability and capability of the process. So I need to run such a diagram, but before to select any product, which is on digitalization, I need to understand how the data are collected, what are the frequency, how do I calculate? And only that I need to look, I can look around to see what's the correct application for that one, then to select it, and then to implement. When I implement, I need to customize the application in such a way that it deserves my needs. another example is the one which I mentioned, which is the HIM system, which is a POC IoT system based on augmented reality. We have a small movie here about these things. What is actually doing that is to support the operator in performing the operation in such a way that he's not forgetting something or he's not getting a wrong part. That's the thing that he's doing. But in the same time, in order to implement the system, also we want to collect some data to measure the performance. So what are the data that we need to collect? We can speak about the time, the cycle time. We can speak about the defect rate. These are some of the things which can be collected from this one. Okay. As an example for the way which can be supported is the fact that this device can have the work instruction introduce it, so he can guide it in this way. If any operation is done wrong, of course the light will become red. It's showing where to put the tool, where to take the tool, what's the correct frequency, and also it's warning when the operator is doing the wrong operation. It's a combination between the human work and the digitalization, which still remains interesting, especially in our country, because we still have a lot of manual work. So from this perspective, it's interesting supporting actually the learning curve, but also the operators which work with small lot sizes. Okay, as a takeover from my brief presentation, before to invest in any automatization, digitalization, consider the larger picture. Understand the entire context, all the variable, then take the correct decision. Design and test your system upfront. I will not advise to take the solution of the programmer, of the IT supplier. You should have your own system already implemented or sketched, and then demand to be adapted the one that you want to buy. Also think about that this application need to have maintenance over the years, and you have to have your own people trained so you can use the continuous improvement along the time. Okay, this was all from my side. If you have any questions, I'm open to it, or you can find out my standards. I'm attending also to this meeting. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, Christian. Thank you for this presentation. The next presentation is digitalization education competitiveness challenges of the future in the industrial field. the speaker, Gheorghe Kazan, General Manager, Hofac Engineering. Gigi, please start your presentation.
Thank you very much, Claudio, and good morning again. And just a second to share the screen. Did you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. So, my name is Gheorghe Kazan. As Claudio mentioned, I'm executive manager in Hofac Engineering, because we are a small company. That means the general is a little bit famous generical name. So I need to discuss a little bit today about the industry 4.0 from the concept, from the point of view of digitalization. So in this context, I will present you two elements which combine digitalization and more depth reverse engineering in a company. So first of all, I want to introduce a little bit our company, Hofac Engineering, which is a CAD/CAM company. We are a specialized supplier for different kind of services in engineering, training, support, pre-sales or post-sales, delivery scanners, and not at least scanning services. So if we go a little bit more, we observe here the framework of digital technologies. And from our point of view, we will be dedicated to cloud computing, augmented reality, 3D printing, and more or then we spoke about digital engineering. And we will see how the digitalization affect not only the engineering department, affect all functions of the company, because we are interested to combine our 3D model with different kinds of function from different companies. So we will spoke about the digital engineering and how they will affect the vertical operation, how we will integrate with vertical operation in a company. In this context, I want to put some question myself and for you. And if we will recognize here some answers, you can appeal to our company to discuss about that. So what means digital collaboration across the enterprise? We spoke about the entire process from design and engineering, test and validation, manufacturing and production, and not at least sales and marketing. Our 3D digital prototyping from Autodesk company cover all these processes. So we go in depth. We spoke about design and engineering. What we have here? We discussed about all process from conception, pass to engineering design, go to simulation, go ahead to documentation the project, and not at least the visualization. That means we will have a 3D model which we can use in all phases of the process, inclusive the revision, inclusive the changes from technological point of view, from customer point of view, etc.
Excuse me, Gigi, one moment, please. We see only one slide. We don't see when you change slides.
Okay.
So just for the moment, we saw only one picture, only one slide.
This is just a second, please. I will stop the share. Okay. I will share screen again, and I will put the screen number one. Okay.
Yes.
From the beginning.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's now, it's okay?
Now, I hope it's okay. We see the first slide and then the second. Yes, it's okay.
Okay. So a little bit faster comeback. We see here the framework of digital technologies across the company included in the concept of Industry 4.0. And we discussed today about the possibility to use solution in cloud computing, augmented reality, 3D printing, all included in the one pylon, means digital engineering with digital collaboration in research and development, digital modeling, mock-up and simulation, and digital manufacturing coordination control. So in this context, we discussed about the digital collaboration across the enterprise. And we from Autodesk, we have the possibility to manage all information from design and engineering, test and validation, manufacturing and production, and sales and marketing. We will see in the next slides how every step will be managed by coordinate the digital prototyping across the enterprise. We go to design and engineering, and we discuss here from conception. Next phase, it is engineering design, because we can have very nice ideas, but we must put in practice. That means in production to realize that. We speak about the simulation to see how will be our product in real life. We generate after that the documentation for final products or different milestones, and not at least the visualization. And we will see in visualization how will be the benefits. If we spoke about test and validation, we have a complete range of solutions which give me every answer from different kind of question. Will my part break? Is my frame strong? Especially here in automotive, we can discuss about the mold flow, and you know mold flow is an international standard for plastic analysis. And we can have, we can simulate the processes and the mold in entire process with our solution. It is important to go to manufacturing and products, and we can speak here about design for manufacturability. How I say before, tool design, CAM program, mold analysis, and not at least about factory optimization, which give us the possibility to arrange the flow inside to a workshop or in the enterprise to obtain the optimizing the time for production. We saw before in first slide about visualization. Visualization could be a very important instrument for sales and marketing, because we can assure the collaboration between us and suppliers, us and customer. We speak about post services, maintenance, where we can deliver it to the customer complete documentation and the last version documentation for our products. And not at least about engineer to order. We can assure all the flow from request to delivery. We have a lot of application dedicated for each step, which was mentioned here. And as a demonstration about that, we have the solution for product design and manufacturing, where you can find here a lot of solution which cover every phase of the process, from sales and bid, design and engineering, production and sales. All this kind of information, we spoke about technical documentation, and not only, we can manage with our solution data management, because we discussed here about the complete product. Not only the technical documentation, all the we include here files from Microsoft, from Adobe, because we need to have complete documentation and the documentation which stay on the base of the decision. Okay, a lot of application from simulation. We spoke about the Nastran, about manufacturing. We spoke the Inventor CAM. Fusion 360, which is a very used cloud solution, Navisource, etc., and not at least 3D Max for obtain some optimum graphical representation. Okay, because I don't know if I mentioned that, we use this solution in our activity like an engineering company, and I can show you some results from our activity. This is 3D modeling and use 3DS for visualization. These are some project of us, and we can see exactly the results of using in the right way the solution. We spoke here, maybe you recognize something. Yes, few slides about our product, because I told you we are using the software. That means we have the ability to supply to our customer the correct way for pre-sales, sales, and implementation of the solution. Another important thing I consider it is the reverse engineering in a company. Many companies have problem with the old component which are destroyed, and they need to recover faster the documentation if don't exist, and delivery for the supplier of manufacturing parts, the 3D model or documentation for realize this kind of part. In this context, we represent in Romania the Polish company Evatronics, which deliver 3D scanners together with a specialized 3D software for reverse engineering. And in the same time, we deliver to our customer services for, we have our own scanner, and we deliver 3D services for our customer. That means if we using the scanners, we have the capacity to assure specialized training for 3D scanning, reverse engineering, quality control, 3D modeling, or other services. Let's see a little bit about this solution. The name of the scanners are is EbicScan. So, okay, we discussed here about scanners, which and you must retain the most important things. Our equipment are certified with VDI VDE 22634 is a specialized standard for scanners. Yes. Here are follow some details about the scanner, because we must understand for different operation, different application, we need different kind of scanners. So we have here Duty Quadro, which is specialized for high precision scanning in aerospace and automotive tool and die workshop. We have here some special information, technical information about the scanners, and I will retain our accuracy. It is for 13 microns from the result of scanning. We can see heavy duty Optima, where here it is dedicated for design centers, CNC centers, or workshops, because we can use inside to the workshop our solution, not need special special condition. And here you can see we have this accuracy here about 9 microns. Okay, for fine precision like fine mechanics, jewelry, electronic products, microblades, we can use fine precision scanner, which have a very good accuracy under the six microns. For the people which are interested, we can deliver information for our products, and we can recommend in according with their field of activity how scanner it is better for use. For the wide range parts, we will launch in the close time a new prototype. The name is MVC Vesuvius. This kind of scanner will be dedicated for wide range part. Okay, this is directly to the scanners. If we spoke about the technology, We can have a complete solution. The scanner not resolve, in fact, complete our problems. So for that, we need, and the scanner will be delivery with the specialized software named Epic Scan for 3D Suite, where we can precise the scan alignment, we can advance hole filling, reduction, and a multi-scan camera and projector. So here we have a little bit productivity tools. The name is Toolkit Box, because with this code markers and the calibrated artifacts, we can obtain a 3 times faster than traditional scanning. With this code markers, we can increase our productivity or measure our part. As I told you, we can use our solution inside of the workshop without some special condition. That means we can use in ambient light condition, and we can use this blue light filters. Now depends about how much have our parts. We can have delivery rotary table in different variants, which could be from 20 kilo to 1000 kilo for a rotary table. That means we will have the capacity to obtain images from many complex shapes or components. Not at least calibration plate is very important time by time to calibrate our scanner. Not every time, but time by time we must calibrate to be sure we will have the precision in measurement. And here I suppose your attention an advantage to use Ebixmatic. Ebixmatic is a special CNC machines, I can see that, which assure us the possibility to automatic scanning procedure. Yes, we can define sequences of measurement. Sometime we can detect the size of object and automatic distance adjustment. For this kind of solution, you will have on the industrial in website to the presentation, you will have you will find a movie here, the name of the file. You will find on this link free movies with Fopak Engineering, and here you can see how is working this Ebixmatic. And because we discussed about the robotics integration, I can show you two integration with universal robot. We have here a cobot, yes, and we have a possibility to replace the operator. We have the possibility for cyclical measurement of production line for repetitive scanning sequences. It is very important for quality control on the specialized line. Again, an application for that you will find on the second movie. Here we have the integration with the robots. And in this moment, we have currently implemented integration with ABB, Yaskawa and Kuka, and we plan for the future. Our colleague from Poland plan for the future integrated with Panyu. If we speak about cobots, we have in this moment implementation with Hans, with universal robots, and plane in close future with Hanwha. Okay, again here you will find a third movie, which means in integration with universal robot, to see exactly how it's working this integration. Okay, this is in some words our proposal for you for optimization the Department of Quality Assurance in the product line. And we invite you, if it is if you are comfortable to travel. We know the situation in this moment in Romania and not in Romania. We invite you to the whole 12.1 stand F62 to visit Evatronics, the supplier of the equipment in Fort Next, which will be between 16 and 19 November in Frankfurt in Germany. Here you will find our contacts. And I will finalize to thank you for your attention, and we hope in a good time for the future to meet physical in exhibition. Thank you very much to all. Thank you, Claudio.
Thank you, Gigi. Dear speakers, Adrian, Christy, Gigi, I would like to thank you for your presentations, and I hope to see you soon on our next events with live presentations. Dear Industry Expo participants, thank you for watching us, and I hope to see you soon on our next events. Thank you, and I wish you very good meetings during the event.
Thank you. Have a nice day.
Thank you too. Bye-bye.
Have a nice day. Bye.
Bye-bye.